Hello and welcome my dear second standard little champs. How are you all? I hope you all are good, you all are fine. So my dear little champs, I welcome you once again to grammar lecture. As you know that we have been revising the grammar chapters. So we have reached now to chapter number 4. We have already completed 3 chapters revision, that is chapter number 1, 2 and 3. So 3 chapters revision we have already completed. Now we have just started chapter number 4, which is pronouns. So my dear little gents, in the previous lecture I just explained you what is pronoun. First I explained you what is noun, that you already might be knowing. So I just reminded you that what is a noun. And then based on that, I explained you that what particularly is pronoun. So I even gave you the example of your mobile games. In your mobile games, when you play, you say, I am a pro player. Similarly, on the basis of that, I explained you what is pronoun. So now I hope that you now know that what exactly is pronoun. And with that, not only the examples but also we have just started our exercise number 1, in which we solved first 5 sentences. Now in exercise number 1 you had to just find the pronoun. So first, in the first 5 sentences we have already found the pronoun. So now we are going to carry forward this lecture, we are going to continue this lecture with sentence number 6 of exercise number 1. So basically we are going to complete exercise number 1 and then we will move on towards exercise number 2 and the other concept. So now I am giving you time to open your rough notebook. Then please write today's date, subject, and then you also have to write the chapter number and the name like I have written here, and then you have to continue with exercise number 1. So if you want to take the new page, it's okay. If you want to continue from the page you were writing in the previous lecture, then also it is all good. So here we will give the heading exercise number 1. I hope that you have also started giving the heading. I will give you few seconds to prepare yourself. I hope my dear students you have started giving the heading. Like I said, you have to write today's date, then subject, chapter number and name. And then give the heading exercise number 1. See, even if you are continuing on the same page from where you have stopped in the previous lecture, still you will have to write the date, today's date, on the particular column. So my dear students, if you remember, the exercise number 1 was circle the pronoun in the sentences. So you had to circle the pronoun in the sentence. In that sentence A, B, C, D and E. That means 5 sentences we have already solved. And another 5 we have to solve now in this lecture. And with this our exercise number 1 will be over. So I hope that now you all are ready to write the questions of exercise number 1, another 5 questions. First 5 we have already solved. So let us write the question. We are going to continue with question F. Pari and I are busy. We are doing the homework. So this is first sentence. Similarly, you have to write the five questions. Please start writing with me. Sentence G also I have written. Now I am on sentence H. Please try to write it as fast as possible. And I will also read the questions once I finish writing it. So I have written now question number I, and the last question I will write for this exercise, and then we are going to solve it. So as you can see, my dear students, I have written another five portions of exercise number one. Please write it down. And then we are going to circle the pronoun in these sentences. Question number F is, Pari and I are busy. Full stop. We are doing the homework. Question G is, I am Karthik. Full stop. I play computer games. Question H is, Adiraj is full of mischief. Full stop. He plays pranks all the time. Question I is, Rishi and I are in the garden. Full stop. We are solving crossword. Question J is, Mr. Saika's son is a good boy. Full stop. He was awarded for helping an old woman. So these are the five questions. Now we are going to find the pronouns and circle them in these questions. So I hope, my dear students, you are ready to find the pronoun. As after this, we are going to move towards another exercise of the same chapter. My dear students, please make sure that you leave one line So I must say that students, whenever you are writing in even the rough book or anywhere, please leave one line after writing each question so that you will have the space to circle the particular word, and you will not just cross the all the sentences, you will not just create the mess over there. So please complete writing this. I'm going to wait for a while so that you will have the sufficient time to write the questions. So now, my dear students, let us solve these questions and get the answer. You have to just circle the pronoun. Now I hope this is just a piece of cake to solve this, because in the previous exercise, majority of the time I have spent explaining you what is a pronoun. So let us circle the pronoun in the sentence sentence F is, Pari and I are busy. We are doing the homework. So almost in the previous exercise, in all the sentences, I have gave you the hint. I have already given you the hint that to find the pronoun, the easiest way is to first recognize which is the noun and the word you think which is replacing that noun is the pronoun. So here the noun is very simple. Pari and I. Pari and I, these two are the noun. So where do you feel in the other part is this noun replaced? So as you can see, Pari and I are busy. But in the second part, they have written we. We are doing the homework. We means what? You and me? No. We means Pari and I. So instead of writing the second time Pari and I, they have written we. So here we is replacing Pari and I. That is why we is a pronoun, and that is why I have circled the pronoun. And I hope now you are also circling the pronoun. Another sentence is, I am Karthik. I play computer games. I am not Karthik, it is just the example. I am Karthik, I play computer games. Now I must tell you, not only Karthik, but my all dear students are playing the games nowadays a lot. Anyways, let us solve this. So which is the noun first of all? Obviously the name, anyone's name is noun. Karthik is noun here. So where do you think Karthik is replaced, or in which way do you think Karthik is replaced? So if you can see, in the first part name is written Karthik, but in the second part I play computer games. Now I told you I means not your sir, I means here Karthik. Karthik is saying that I play. So instead of writing Karthik, second time I is used. So this second I is the pronoun, not this. Okay, sentence H. Adiraj is full of mischief. Full stop. He plays pranks all the time. So now here, my dear students, which is the noun? Noun is Adiraj. And where and how is the name Adiraj replaced? So if you can see, he plays the prank. He means who? Adiraj. So the word Adiraj, the name, the noun Adiraj is replaced by the pronoun he. So here he is the pronoun. I hope that you are also circling the pronoun as I have done. Sentence I. Rishi and I are in the garden. Which is the noun? Obviously, Rishi and I. These two are the nouns. See, I is the personal pronoun. It is always capital. If it is written, just I is written alone, then wherever it is there, it is capital. Anyways, this was just the extra knowledge. Rishi and I are in the garden. Now, Rishi and I, these two are the nouns. But in the second part, if you see, we are solving crossword. We means who? Rishi and I, obviously. So here, Rishi and I is replaced with the pronoun we. Now the last question, Mr. Saika's son is a good boy. He was awarded for helping an old woman. Now first you have to underline the noun. Mr. Saika is the noun and his son is also the noun. Now which is the pronoun? Pronoun is he. Instead of using Mr. Saika's son's name, here he is written to show his son. So he is pronoun. Please have a look on the answers and solve it. Now as you can see on the board, I have circled the pronouns with the green pen so that you will be able to understand and recognize which are the pronouns. And with the black marker, I have underlined the noun, the name. It can be the proper noun or the common noun, doesn't matter here. It's just that you should have the knowledge of noun and that's it. So, I hope that you are even checking your answers, verifying it once if you have solved it by looking on the board or by on your own. After this, one interesting thing, I'm going to write it on the board, which is going to really draw your attention and keep you spellbound and make you understand what is the use of pronoun exactly and how easy it is to write the sentences if you use pronoun. So basically, why is the pronoun the concept in the grammar? That is what you're going to really understand now after writing this. So my dear students, that's it. Now I'm going to clear the board and I'm going to write the example which I'm talking for what I'm talking about. So I'm going to clear the board here. Now students, you have to just sit and observe. You don't have to write anything. So please fold your hands. Keep your pencil, book, eraser, whatever you have at one place and carefully listen to me, look onto the board. So your kind attention should be here on the board and on me. So I'm going to write something by which you will really understand what exactly for is the pronoun used. So as you can see, I have written something. Please read it. Now, I am still going to write one more important thing. Till then, you can read these sentences. Not exactly two sentences, six sentences are there. One is this part and another is this part. So I have written both with a different color of the pen to just explain you the difference. So now, my dear students, let me explain you why have I written this. The first part says that Samira is in class. Samira loves to read. Samira is reading a book on animals. How many times the name is repeated? Samira, Samira, Samira. So in three sentences, three times the name is repeated. Samira is in the class. Samira loves to read the book. Samira is reading the books on animals. Isn't it boring? Doesn't this sounds very weird and boring? It is very monotonous to repeat the name. But here if you look, Samira is in the class. She loves to read the book. She is reading a book on animals. So how different this looks? Why? Have a look and I will explain you. As you can see on the board, I have written two parts, one with the blue and another with the black. Just read it for a second or two. Again, I am going to come near the board and explain you why have I written this. This is very important. So as you understood what is pronoun, you need to even understand. Okay, this is pronoun, but why do we use the pronoun? Why it is introduced in the English grammar? Whatever you have, the equipment, the use is necessary. You should know why is this pronoun the topic in the English grammar. So now let me explain you. I suppose that you have read. I suppose that you have read it once. My dear students, in this part, Samira is repeated three times. Because here only three sentences are there. Full stop, second one, full stop and third one. Only three sentences are there. That is why the name Samira is repeated three times. Just imagine if you are asked to write this paragraph on Samira. 10 sentences will contain the 10 names repeatedly. How boring it will be. Isn't it so? That is why pronoun is introduced so that you don't have to write the name again and again. And Samira is a very short name. Just imagine if the name is too big, containing the first name, middle name and the last name. You will have to write again and again the full name. For example, my name is Rohan C. Tarwani. So if you are asked to write the paragraph on me, for approximately you are writing 10 lines. So 10 times you have to repeat Rohan C. Tarwani, Rohan C. Tarwani. Will it not sound very monotonous and boring? That is why the concept of pronoun is used so that you don't have to repeat the names and then you can just complete it in a shot. If it is a girl, you can use she or her. If a boy is there, you can use he or his. Similarly, pronouns are there for the singular and plural both. So here, to avoid writing Samira again and again, pronoun she is used and that's it. So Samira is only used one time and then pronoun is working. Again, have a look and think upon whatever I have explained now. Students, to understand the use is equally important as to understand the topic. Unless you will not understand the use, maybe some complex questions will be there which you will not be able to solve it. So, in this lecture, it was very much significant to explain you the use of pronoun so as to give you the deep knowledge about the topic pronoun. And like I said that these topics in your second standard, third standard, whichever is there, is a kind of pillar for you to construct the high level building for your 10th and 12th standard. So I hope you have understood now what is the use of a pronoun. So with this, my dear students, I end my today's lecture. In today's lecture, first of all, we have completed our remaining sentences of exercise number 1. And then today I have explained you what exactly is the use of pronoun. So now I hope you enjoyed understanding this, you enjoyed this lecture. If you want, you can watch the same lecture again and again, as it is well said that practice makes one perfect. It is like practice makes a man perfect. Not only man, a girl, a boy, a woman, I mean to say, everyone can make themselves perfect by practicing. So especially whenever I give the explanation video, I suppose that you should watch 2 or 3 times to understand the concept more precisely. So with this, my dear students, I end my today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will solve the next exercise, which is exercise number 2, which is based on this concept. So my dear students, wait for my another interesting lecture in which we will solve the next exercise. Till then, take care of yourselves. Goodbye.